Kurt Browning is Mr. Excitement. He does everything, and that will include a quad tonight. He should go all out, all or nothing. And Toller, you spoke to him just a few moments ago.
Yes, I did. He's very concentrated, very calm, and a very determined young man. Quad. It's very difficult to actually determine a triple and a quad that had a slight three turn behind it. But if we remember Vern Taylor's triple axel in Ottawa, the first on record, he also had a three turn behind it. Triple axel followed that quad. I don't know where the energy comes from, because if it were me, I think I'd just sort of finish the performance right there. Difficult combination, a triple sow cow a mile high followed by a double loop. Kurt Browning has catapulted into the A group in 1 year. One could also say in one competition, the Olympics in Calgary, where he astounded the entire audience. They'll simply run out of jumps and certainly run out of marks. A triple combination.
Something new.
Well, Kurt is an exponent of the new breed of skating, of which there are very few, but they are the super athletes and also athletes with great personality and charisma. The other that comes to mind would have to be Viktor Petrenko, bronze medalist in the Olympics in Calgary. The program leaves something to be desired. It doesn't have the slickness of an Orser or a Boitano. That will all come. But athletically, there are few skaters that could ever compete with that kind of technique. It was really one of a kind. Probably can't get the very highest marks, but this will be one of the superior performances tonight, for sure.
And he's getting a standing ovation, certainly from all the Canadians, and I think there are more Canadians than any other nationality other than the Hungarians here, more Canadians than Americans, I'm sure, certainly more Canadian flags, a big contingent over from the Armed Forces base in Laarwes, Germany, and look at this.
That's Elizabeth Manley and Christine Huff. This was the quad, only the most discerning eye could see it. For many people in the audience wouldn't really have twigged on the fact that it was a quad. Followed, I think, by the triple axel. Any one of these jumps can, a program can be built around. They are so extremely difficult. They appear to be easy, but the risk is phenomenal.
First set of marks coming out for Kurt Browning, who obviously seemed to enjoy himself too out there. We'd watched him in practice doing, one foot, he says. Doggone right, it was one foot. We've watched him with those quads in practice. And
meet you at the airport.
Talking about them here all day today. Judges have obviously been wondering a little bit.
Well, a Kurt Browning is a wild card that comes into the competition too early to allow the 5.9s and 5.8s to come out, I think. But certainly, it was a very leveling kind of performance, and many, many people will snap to attention and realize that this is one of the great potential champions for the future.
And the first set of marks now are coming up. 5.7s and 5.8s, a 5.6 from Poland, but 5.8 from Austria, Australia, the Soviet Union, Canada, and Sweden.
Ted, what this means is probably that it could be one of the top performances of the evening, certainly in the top five. I would guess probably with the skaters to come about fourth, but 5.8 is very difficult to beat.
Excellent marks, of course, for technical. Let's see what his marks now for artistic impression are going to be, and they, in most cases, are down just a little bit. He did so much, but as you pointed out, the program is still to be rounded out, but that is by far the top program so far in this free skating.
5.7, 5.8, 5.6. Thank you.